time for the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show on the Columbus River Dragons Radio Network. Tonight's show is brought to you by John Emerald Distilling, Southern States Bank, BioLife Plasma, Midas Total Car Care, Vectorply, and PMB Broadcasting. Now to catch you up on all things River Dragons hockey, let's start tonight's show with Zach DeBozart.
Thank you very much, Brian Thomas. Welcome in to the studios here at PMB Broadcasting, the Columbus River Dragons John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show. I'm Zach DeBozart. Scott Brand is here with me today. Scott, how are we doing?
What are you doing?
I'm not entirely sure.
Well, we're on delay here, I think, with our...
There we go. That's fixed.
Can we put the headphones back on?
Yes, now you can put the headphones back on.
So I can or can't swear?
No, you cannot swear. Don't be doing that. You did so good all weekend.
You know, it's my show, and all of a sudden, now we're late. All of a sudden, there's a computer glitch. Then we can't find the key to the liquor cabinet. Thank you, Brian Thomas.
Wow, we're doing so many bad things to you right now.
Welcome to college radio. Welcome to an hour of college radio on a
John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show.
I don't know why I don't bring my own flask with me like I should have.
Jerome Bichard will hopefully be joining us about halfway through the show. The reason why it's Scott and I right now, the team is at practice. Opted for a skate at 5 o'clock today, and the reason for that...
Because there's a lot of burglars in the area, and when they have courtroom. Mm-hmm. They got that courtroom tied up, so we can't...
Well, yeah, and there's obviously the building turnover in the Civic Center, the Columbus Rapids. They played on Monday, and so they were changing over from turf to ice and couldn't get our normal morning skate, so the guys on the team opted for an afternoon skate. So we're hoping to have Jerome Bichard on in probably about 20 minutes or so from now. Again, they got on the ice around like 5:15 or so. So until then, you got myself, Zach DeBozart, Scott Brand with you here on the show, talking about everything that happened River Dragons up in Port Huron. And Scott, you're very qualified for the show for once. Saw all three games, obviously didn't entirely go our way. Only 3 points out of 9, but I think when you really look in the long-term scheme of things, 9 points out of 15 for the five-game road swing, if you will, back-to-back weekends on the road. Very good for the River Dragons. I think something to build off of ahead of this big homestand.
Well, yeah, if we want to go that far back, I mean, it was okay. I mean, listen, I think, we got beat Friday night, just got beat by a better team. I don't think we were as prepared as we could have been Saturday night. We looked great, and then Sunday, we were awful. I mean, just to be blunt, and... By the way, what did you put in this cough drop? Good Lord.
Well,
I'm sweating over here. But no, Zach, you know what? Yeah, you look at it, you go on the road. Anytime you get 500 on the road, I mean, that's pretty good. And obviously, you want to be at least 750 at home. So, so that was good. I can't speak to Delaware, and you guys talked about that last week. We can talk about Port Huron.
Yeah, Port Huron, obviously, only taking 3 points out of the 9 Friday's game. Did not go our way starting there. A 6-3 defeat to the Port Huron Prowlers. A game, though, that I really liked the River Dragons fight. Port Huron took the early 2-0 lead through 20 minutes through Adam Morgan and Mike Moroso, two guys that I think the Prowlers will be very excited to have in their lineup going down the stretch, and obviously you'll see throughout tonight's show when we talk about them why. But then Jake Krupp scores a goal, second period, 1:26 in, makes it 2-1, and then Dalton Jay finds an incredible deflection goal. You're thinking 3-1, ah, dang it, they answered back. 19 seconds later, Petro Antonio scores, and then Petro Antonio adds another one later in the second. So you're talking 6 minutes into the second period, all of a sudden the offenses have opened back up and scores 3-3. Great, I thought, response in the middle of that period. And just showed it really doesn't matter what time of game it is. River Dragons have that ability to go in, fight, and come back from something.
No, I agree with you. I mean, I like the way they came back. And, they got a slow start. And you can say bus legs or whatever you want to. But I just think that we were thinking it was the old Port Huron team we beat down here 10-0. Good job to come back and tie her up, and then after that, kind of took the rest of the night off.
Unfortunately so. About halfway through the game, Gino Mini scores one from the right point, and then Adam Morgan finishes it off with two more, so it was a hat trick for Adam Morgan as he picked up first star of the night. Gino Mini had a Gordie Howe hat trick after he fought Edgar Zozulich at some point during that, and then Dalton Jay picked up third star with a goal and an assist in that one. So while the weekend didn't start the way we wanted to, transition over to Saturday, much better game for the River Dragons. And here is the very exciting part of all this. First of all, Saturday's game, hope everyone enjoyed it on WTVM, Bounce 9.2. A lot of fun. Some stories I'm sure we'll tell from the TV side of things later on in tonight's show between you and I, Scott. But Got started on the right foot. Paul Frazier, his first of the year, a shorthanded goal, 7:59 into the first. River Dragons scored three shorthanded goals this weekend against Port Huron, who fans might remember last year, Port Huron just tore us up with shorthanded goals. It didn't matter that Port Huron was fourth place in a four-team league. They were going to find ways to get shorthanded goals on us, it seems like. So nice to see that that trend reversing a little bit here in this part of the season.
Yeah, Saturday night, I mean, what can you say about the special teams? You know, shorthanded goals, and then I think a goal that scored right after we got done being shorthanded, and power play looked good. And you're right, it's nice to do it back to Port Huron because they are so famous for that. They're famous for breakaways. I'll tell you, you know, we only gave up five breakaways on the weekend, and the over-under was nine that I had. And so that was good. And
I will let you know, last week, Jerome said the over-under was zero, so he'll be disappointed in that. But, I mean, really, five in three games.
And I think Dalton Jay only scored two goals on the weekend.
He had the deflection goal and then that one on
breakaway.
Sunday. Yeah, it was a breakaway, yes. But
and then, you know, that was good. But you take the good, you take the bad, and there you have the facts of life. But no, I mean, you know, it's good to see when special teams work. And what was good was the penalty kill. I liked was the fact that we finally were in the box. My biggest problem with the team, I think, Friday night was we were taking long shifts. I mean, and we started getting into it Sunday night because everybody wants to be the hero, right? You want to stay out there, you want to get the goal. You know, put your 45 seconds of work in and get off the ice. The other thing, our defensemen and our wingers, when they come back, instead of standing there looking around, go to a man and put your stick on him. You got to tie guys up, and that's where, Port Huron backdoored us two, three times just killed momentum of the game.
Matt Graham and then Mike Moroso scored in the late stages of the first and early stages of the second. So Prowlers had a 2-1 lead, and they held on to that for quite a bit in the second period on Saturday. And this was one, River Dragons just seemed to bide their time, and then all of a sudden, floodgates open. Josh Petrantonio, power play goal, 13:20 in. 54 seconds later, Jay Krupp answers, so it's 3-2 Columbus. Then 22 seconds left to go in the period, another power play goal, Austin Doe, Adam Vanelli, and then Dalton Anderson shorthanded. By the way, Dalton Anderson, so that's a second shorthanded goal in that game. Dalton Anderson, I think he has three shorthanded goals now because he picked up one on Sunday. He has scored six all year.
Shorthanded goals?
Half of Dalton Anderson's goals this season for the River Dragons have come shorthanded. Just a bit of a penalty kill specialist is what Ando's becoming. But when you look at all that, Scott, five goals unanswered for a time, basically over 20-plus minutes of hockey. Adam Morgan got one back on the power play to make it 6-3, but then Jay Krupp's empty netter to make it 7-3, sealed the deal for the River Dragons to win. Austin Doe, no goals, three assists. Paul Frazier, a goal and two assists. Hunter Bersani, a goal and an assist as well. Jay Krupp had two goals. And remember, this was the game, because Edgar Zoslinch was suspended, Josh Petrantonio with a goal and an assist was spending back on defense.
Well, and we had a spirited discussion today because Josh was in the office and he was here with Jerome. And so I walked in, closed the door to give my obvious hockey knowledge and asked Josh, hey, why don't you just stay back in the point, you know? He's a point guy now. You can't convert him back to defense. And although I seriously thought he played a heck of a role on defense. I don't know if he really got caught out.
I mean, he really did. I know he took a penalty defensively, but that was one of those, like, he had to take it, guy was driving the net type things. But I mean, talking with him, you know, he said he enjoyed it. I mean, granted, when I talked to him after the game, he said he can't remember the last time he played a full game on defense like that. But just from my view, I mean, very physical, didn't really put too much out of line. Of course, playing with Ian White, obviously has a lot of confidence in his D partner, 500 games in the NHL on the other side for him. So I really thought, hey, heck of a showing for the captain and stepping up in a really big way, you know, when the team needed it, had a hole in the back end. He goes back there, does more than enough to fill that hole, and River Dragons come out with a big win on the other side of it.
I'd like to see him stay back there. I really thought he didn't like it.
You know what's funny is, though, I remember being in the office when you were having this discussion with him, and you used I think you get more ice time out of it, which in theory, I feel like most places defensemen would get more ice time, but in a league like the Fed, because you know you're only dressing usually 10 forwards and six defensemen, that's an even number of forward lines, full forward lines to full D lines. So not exactly there. And we had our in-stat scouting department that send us reports after every game. According to them, Pietrantonio had 22 and a half minutes Friday, only about 20 minutes and some change on Saturday. So he actually went down a little bit on the ice time. But I'll be honest with you, I mean, I thought he was still just as effective.
I did too, you know. You know, I'm used to when we played. We usually went with a 5D rotation.
Yeah, right.
You know, 1 and 2, and then 3, 4, and 5 would rotate. So, but anyway, no. Listen, that's the type of talented player he is. He can do everything. You know, at some point during the game, since we're probably still on the ice, and I can say this, so the goalies can't hear me. Maybe he can play goal next week.
Well, we kind of wondered that because on Sunday, we didn't know who was going to get the start between Rutledge and Bailey McBurney. That we kind of joked before the game, hey, what's it going to be? Maybe it's Josh Pietrantonio. It was not. It was actually Bailey McBurney. And Josh Pietrantonio scored the first goal for the River Dragons in this game, answering back from a Cade Lambden tally, 1-1. And Port Huron got three straight in the middle of the first to early second. Mike Moroso, Stephen Fowler, Dalton Jay. I mean, Mike Moroso had himself just a heck of a weekend. If you put Moroso, Fowler, and Adam Morgan on a line for Port Huron, you combine that with Jay Graham and usually, you know, guys like Parkhouse or Federley when he was there, you know, all of a sudden Port Huron's two lines deep, and that's two strong scoring lines. We really saw the depth of Port Huron this weekend, and well, that's what gave them some results.
You know, I'm interested if they're going to stay that way. If they're going to stay there, they just come in, you know, for the grudge match or come in for the weekend mm-hmm. to have some fun, you know, three games, three nights. I don't know where Port Huron goes next, but it'll be interesting to stay because I think if they stay together, they are going to start winning some more games.
Mike Moroso, by the way, who hadn't played in the league since December 26, 2021, had a goal and an assist in a 4-2 win against Carolina with whoever he might have been playing with. I think it was Port Huron at the time. Past that, though, that one game, he hadn't played since March 8th of 2020, literally when COVID shut that season down in the Fed, 19-20. So had one game in the 21-22 season and then said, all right, here we go with three-game weekend against Columbus. All he did in those three games, three goals, two assists for 5 points, and he actually picked up third star of the night on the Sunday game. Dalton Anderson, another shorthanded goal, as we mentioned, but then Stavros Soilis, third period sort of put the dagger in. It was in the early stages. It was 5-2. But as you could tell, the way things were, you know, going throughout the game, Columbus was always just playing from behind on Sunday and had their chances. I think there were a couple, especially in the second period. If it would have gotten to 4-3 before we got into the third period, thought it would have been a brand new hockey game. But Port Huron keeping it at 4-2, heading into the third, you knew they had momentum and really were just at some points feeling like they were just salting away the clock at the end of it.
Yeah, you got to take your hat off to Matt Graham and Port Huron. They beat us, and you're right. I think if we could have got a goal, I think we had one dance across the goal line at one point. But what, you know, you move on. Thank God we're out of there, you know, and I don't think we have to go back up there till
so the end of the season, April 15th and 16th. Our regular season finale will be in McMoran Arena.
And I know the scheduler wouldn't have us see them within the next 2-3 weeks, so we don't have to see them.
I have some bad news for you, Scott. We can talk about the upcoming games here in a little bit, but we're just past the quarter of the hour mark, so let's take a break. When we come back, we will take a look at the upcoming games for the River Dragons. It's an 8-game homestand over the next 4 weeks. Lots of chances to come out and see your River Dragons. I'm Zach DeBozart. He's Scott Brand on the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show. Back after this on the Columbus River Dragons Radio Network.
The Chattahoochee's favorite place for spirits in the valley is John Emerald Distilling Company in Opelika. Conveniently located in beautiful downtown Opelika, they're open Monday through Saturday for tours, tasting, and bottle sales. Not in Opelika? No problem. From Birmingham to Columbus, there's plenty of places where John Emerald originals are sold. Check out some of their favorite recipes at johnemeralddistilling.com and give them a follow on social media at JED Spirits on Twitter and Instagram.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call 706-324-6661.
Dressing for success is as easy as 1, 2, 3 with Wade Cleaners. Drop off your garment at any one of their 5 convenient branches or call their valet manager to pick them up. Go do something fun. Walk your dog, eat a hot fudge sundae, or go to a movie. Leave the dirty laundry to them. Pick up your professionally cleaned garments or have them delivered at no additional charge to your home or office. Yes, you too can dress for success with Wade Cleaners. Oh, and don't forget the little people as you move up in the world.
Looking to bring the whole crew out to a game? Group nights are for you. Groups of 10 or more get special ticket pricing and exclusive merchandise and experience add-ons that will make your game at the Civic Center a night to remember. For more information on group rates and packages, visit rdragons.com/tickets or call our ticketing manager at 706-940-0476. Ask about all the great perks we can provide your group. Work friends, family functions, there's no group too big for us to handle. But it starts by visiting rdragons.com/tickets.
We are back here on the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show. It's a Tuesday night, a little bit after 6:15, or a segment or so in. I'm Zach DeBozart. President and General Manager Scott Brand is joining us on the show today. We know Jerome Bichard just yet. The guy has had a 5:15 skate, opted for the late afternoon skate after the building was being changed over from turf to ice. So get a chance to get the legs under you, get themselves prepared for a 3-game weekend against the Carolina Thunderbirds. But that skate, we understand, is over. It's just a little bit, so hoping to see Jerome at some point before the show is over.
If we're up to me, that skate's going an extra hour, and you know why.
Well, yeah, you know, it was a tough weekend for the River Dragons for sure. But again, the way I look at it, you know, 5 games in a row on the road, taking 9 points, you're happy with that?
You keep going back to the 9 points. Let's stop. It was Delaware.
What do you want me to say about that, Scott? I mean, listen. You had props for Delaware. They have a line. They have a team.
If we go back far enough, we won the championship.
You know what? Fine. I guess so. But now we look ahead.
Let's look ahead.
To 8 straight games at home over the next 4 weekends. First up is a 3-set against the Carolina Thunderbirds.
Oh, I was going to say, hopefully we get to see somebody new, like the Black Bears or the Rabbits.
Not exactly.
So Rabbits or...
The Carolina Thunderbirds are a 3-game set coming up this weekend.
Yeah,
we'll tell you about that in a minute.
Actually, we haven't seen them in about a month.
We haven't, so that's nice. Then for 2 games after Carolina...
It can't be Port Huron.
It'll be Port Huron.
Oh, wonderful. Jeez,
then there's a bye weekend after that, though. February 4th through the 6th, I believe, is the Friday through Sunday. And that's a bye weekend, so a chance for the guys to rest, recover, and just, you know, get ready for the rest of the season, essentially. And then right after that, you go jump right back into a 3-3 against the Delaware Thunder. So it's been a lot of recent opponents that you're playing here coming up. Now, when the calendar turns over into late February and early March, that's when you're going to see a lot of variety in opponents. That's when we got Watertown, we got Danbury. We actually make a trip to Danbury, and then they come back. We play them, I think, 2 out of 3 weekends in terms of a home and away. I think, I don't know who's in the middle of all that, but you're going to start seeing some new opponents here really soon. In fact, these 2 games with Port Huron after the Carolina set, you will not see Port Huron again until the second to last weekend of the season. That's a whole 2-month break for the guys to simmer down and stop hating each other.
Until we get them in the playoffs. But, you're right. It's good to, fans, you get a chance to see us. It's January now. We know the holidays are over, so come on out this weekend. And there's a lot of specials going on, too. And then the following weekend, and then a weekend off. And then February, you have 1 weekend to see us. We kind of got the short end of the stick there with the building. And so you've only got 1 weekend to see us, and we hope that you'll come out. I know that I was going to say the 12th is scheduled military night, and that's a big night, and then lots of things going on.
All I know is you look at it, college football's over, so Georgia people and Alabama people can come together for a united cause of the River Dragons. They no longer have to be at war, and... I know the NFL playoffs are still going on, but let's be honest. The Falcons are out. And
the Saints are out.
Unless you have some rooting interest somewhere, it's hockey season now here in the South, so we can't wait to bring the people out for this. And it starts up with a great theme night coming up on Friday, Education Night, presented by Kinetic Credit Union, River Dragons, Carolina Thunderbirds. That's on a Friday night. If you're an educator, staff, or faculty member, or a student, you bring in your school ID to the River Dragons offices between now and Thursday the 20th before our offices close at 5 p.m., and you get a special ticket. Offer 2 tickets for $16, and you can buy those in any quantity you need to come out to the game on Friday.
Yeah, I think the most you can buy is a set of 2000s.
Yeah, I think at that point, that's where the building capacity and fire code starts to become a problem.
Yeah, so I mean, listen, tickets already out. Student, it's a cheap date, you know. So,
and you know it's going to be feisty because Carolina's in town.
Yeah, and you know Zach's probably still got his ID, so I'm sure he'll bring his date to the game.
I just might somewhere. I might have to dig it out.
I
but
bet you do. You know still got that. Where'd you go?
Grand Valley State.
Grand Valley State. That's right. The broadcasting mecca of the Midwest. What's going on Saturday?
Saturday we've got a 4 for $48 deal presented by McDonald's.
Are there even tickets left on that one? They were going pretty quick. So if you're going, better.
The 4 for $48 is a limited quantity deal. I know. We are running a little bit low on those tickets. So if you want to get in on that deal, call sooner rather than later, 706-507-4625. That's the River Dragons offices. Just ask for the ticketing department, the 4 for $48 deal. Or you can go online, handle it yourself, rdragons.com/MCDdeal. That's MCD-deal, D-E-A-L. And 4 for $48 could be yours. 4 upper-level tickets, 4 souvenir hats, and 4 meal certificates. Good for a breakfast, lunch, or dinner combo at any of our local Chattahoochee Valley area McDonald's. The next time you'll be able to have that game or that offer, I think, will be February 12th against the Delaware Thunder. So you have two opportunities in this 8-game homestand to utilize 4 for $48. But only select games and only a certain amount of ticket quantities available. So again, 706-507-4625 to get your tickets for that one. Now that we've got the fun stuff out of the way, we're going to actually talk about the River Dragons and Thunderbirds because, let's be honest, you're right, Scott. We haven't seen each other in about a month. I believe December 18th was the last time we played each other. So it was about a month ago from now. And, you know, it was a pretty spirited set. The River Dragons came away with a couple of wins. So what are we expecting? Because this Carolina team has been through its ups and downs so far.
Knuckle Dragon. We're going to see some. Listen. I'm going to tell you what is the two teams. There's nobody left from our area. I think there's two players left. That squad, right?
On the Carolina squad or Columbus squad?
Carolina, from when we were there.
Maybe even two. I'm not entirely sure. It looks like a whole brand new roster to me.
It does, and so it's kind of a brand new roster since we played them. We don't like each other. I mean, I think the fans really. Hate each other's team, but the players we have a lot of respect for them, but it's a rivalry. I mean that's the team that you're going to go out and beat, and they're going to come down here, and you know they've got some players that I don't they got some players I think frankly are dirty.
By the way, quick correction: the previous time the River Dragons Thunderbirds played was a series win for the Dragons, 4 points out of 6, because it was an overtime win for Carolina in Biloxi. That was the Friday game that had about 68 or 7,000 people there, and then of course since been broken by the December 30th game, it was 8,600. But that was a 4-3 overtime win for Carolina, and then Columbus in the return game in the Civic Center won that 6-2. So that was 4 points out of 6 for the weekend series win, but they split it in terms of total victories. But still, I mean, it's going to be competitive, and I think this is a Carolina team that's starting to feel, I don't want to say a little bit desperate, but I think maybe realizing that where they sit in the standings is not where they want to be. And as you approach the halfway mark of the season, you know, the fact that the league operates on points percentage, right? When you get to the halfway point, all of a sudden, it becomes that much harder to move your points percentage up and down as opposed to earlier in the season when there's not that much body of work to be fighting against. So Carolina right now finds themselves at a basically a 500 level team, and they've been battling with Binghamton for 4th/5th spot and top 4. You're talking about potentially making playoffs. You know, Carolina's going to be realizing down the stretch, every single game is going to be important. So, you know, games like we saw on Friday, where we were talking about during around the FPHL, where the Thunder were up 4-0 at one point, Carolina storms back, has the lead, but then gives up a goal with an extra attacker and then loses in overtime. You know, that could be a point that, you know, they could be ruined themselves, or 2 points, I would say, that they would ruin, you know, if it comes down to it at the end of the year. You never know, but as they get deeper and deeper in the season, and they're still sitting on that bubble, they're going to become more and more desperate, I think.
Well, they are. And they do have a lot of talent. They're well coached. And here's the thing: is you're exactly right. Is they're not used to being this. Remember, that's a new franchise, and you know the GM that put it together before did a phenomenal job, and they're used to being in the upper 1 and 2 spots of the league. And so right now they're kind of getting their tail handed to them a little bit. And they got scared on Friday. They came away with a point. but they are going to be dangerous to play. I mean, because I think you're right, Zach. I think if they're losing, they're going to try and punish you. They're going to come into our building. They're going to try and, I think, run us off the ice. And, you know, it's going to be how we react. Because, you know, you have a couple guys that will throw punches and checks, and then they'll turtle. And we have to be smart enough not to jump them. Because we saw what happened. The league just suspended player for Delaware, you know, for fisticuffs. To me, it was executed. They gave him too many games. Alex Basie, right?
Yeah, Alex Basie. He got into something with the new Thunderbirds captain, John Butito, which I'll be honest, I have not yet to see film on. I've only kind of heard the stories.
But I mean, heard things.
It was a pretty ugly fight. And yeah, Basie, who has since returned from suspension because he only had to serve the one game. You know, they can be a pretty feisty team. We know that. We've seen it before. It doesn't matter really who's on the ice. I mean, you talk about, all right, fine, only two or three players since when Columbus came into the league since then have been part of that team. And that's when the rivalry was really fierce at the very start. But I mean, it doesn't just cool off and you know, go away overnight. You know, especially the fans really drive it too. I mean, the fans just, you know, Columbus despises Carolina, it seems like, when they come here, and the fans in Carolina, they despise Columbus when they come there. You know, it's passionate, it's heated, it's a good Southern hockey rivalry.
It is, and it sells tickets.
And it does. We're at the bottom of the hour. Let's take another break. When we come back, we'll see if we can't get an ETA on Jerome. Maybe he'll be in the studio with us. If not, Scott and I have some stories to tell from a little bit behind the scenes. Obviously, being on television the night before, or on Saturday night, was a lot of fun. So we'll get into that a little bit. And we'll also hopefully hear from Jerome as we move on the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show. Don't go anywhere. Columbus River Dragons Radio Network.
At Southern States Bank, the Common Sense Bank, we're a true community bank that supports the places we serve. Our people live, work, and play in your community. And you will find us cheering for the River Dragons right alongside you in the stands. With convenient locations throughout Alabama and Georgia, we're never too far away to handle any of your financial concerns. Call, click, or come by and see how we can help you make sense out of your banking. Visit us online at southernstatesbank.net. Southern States Bank, member FDIC. Equal housing lender. NMLS number 410611.
A lot of more people turn to Sun South for quality John Deere equipment. Our customers say it best.
The reason I'm a Sun South customer is because of their customer service and because of their sales staff.
The local service is outstanding.
When I think of Sun South, I think of partners.
Right now at Sun South, get 0% financing for 72 months on select John Deere equipment. Sun South, equipment for those that do.
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Offer expires January 31st, 2022.
Let Shred Away, a division of the Overbeek Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shred Away, a division of the Overbeek Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shred Away, 706-577-9668.
Stay up to date with everything Columbus River Dragons by following the team on social media. Stay in the know with all the team news on Facebook and Instagram. Get live in-game updates via Twitter. And of course, catch every game on the YouTube page. Following is easy. Search at @C_River Dragons on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. It's never been easier to stay in the loop with your favorite hockey team. So what's stopping you? Drop us a fun comment or send us a message and we may just feature you on the feeds. That's @C_River Dragons on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube.
We are back here at the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show, a little bit past the bottom of the hour here on Tuesday night. I'm Zach DeBozart. He's Scott Brand. And we're trying an experiment here, Scott. I think maybe we've got this to work here where Jerome Bichard is going to be joining us in over the phone. Jerome, can you hear us right now? Jerome, are you there? That would be a no.
Phil from Phoenix City apparently calling.
So I have screwed something up. Now, in my defense,
in your defense, you're sober.
Yeah, well, no, in my defense, and you were apparently laughing sober? At that. I apparently messed something up here. So
you need your Get More box.
Yeah, I don't know. I had to give myself a quick crash course on the phone system here, trying to figure it out. Thought I had him for a moment.
Where is he?
Just got off the ice, so trying to make it in. But I also said, hey, why don't we try and just get you in on the phone? But
how long has Beach been in the city? Like 20 years now?
Probably about 20, 25 years.
You don't think we can get a police escort for him?
I think if we ask nice enough, we probably could.
By the way, I have breaking news at some point.
Oh, boy. Well, you know what? Tell you what. You want to go to that? Maybe I can see if I can retrieve Jerome?
I don't know.
You're going to have to fill about 2 minutes, though, and I know how you feel about filling.
Hold on. Let me get one of these.
one of your fish pastes in there?
Listen, I'll give a shout out to Fisherman's Friend.
Okay, go ahead. I'm going to try it.
Tastes like the inside of a fisherman's boot, but it works. Listen, I got to tell you, is first of all, I'm proud of being on PMB and you know, being on 106.99 here, and you know, I listen to the Boomer side, but regardless, they're a great partner. I also absolutely we love our people up in Jordan Broadcasting. I mean, we're in Lineville, Alabama. We're in LaGrange, Georgia, and we're in Noonan, and they've been great and a great partner. You know, our TV partner, Channel 9 and Bounce TV, and I just got word now, it's official, that we've expanded our TV family. And so for those of you who catch us over in Auburn and Opa-locka, this is a big deal for us, as we'll be on TV 18 over there. It's over the air. You can get it in Valley City. You can get it in Opa-locka. And so we'll be televising, I think, 5 or 6 Sunday games, starting with this Sunday. So that's huge, huge news for us. We're expanding the footprint, expanding the market, and we want to thank everybody at Jordan Communication. You guys are great partners. And if there's any sponsors out there, please let Jordan Communication thank them and PMB and Channel 9 and Bounce TV and everybody else. All right. Did I fill enough?
I think so. I think I did this right.
Oh, by the way, you're going to have to get pretty on Sunday.
Yeah,
so
I'm aware.
You know what that means? Bath time Saturday night.
No, I just heard the end of it there. Let's see if we got him here. Jerome, you with us here on the show?
Sure am. How are you?
Hey, Jerome. All right. I figured it out. So glad to have you on here. Obviously, Scott.
Oh, look who's phoning it in.
See what you did there.
Sorry. You just got off the ice, fellas.
Yeah.
Scott. Skating them? You were skating them? That's what I like.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah. We had a pretty good hard skate for a nice long road trip and got home safe, and good to see a little bit of snow, but happy to be down south where it doesn't do that very often.
Obviously, you know, we were talking about the previous weekend earlier in the show, but let's get your thoughts on it, Jerome. Only 3 points out of 9, and honestly, despite the seemingly lopsided score lines, it still felt like a very competitive weekend. Obviously, one River Dragons could have won. What was your overall takeaways from Port Huron and then maybe the whole road excursions, Delaware and Port Huron as a whole?
Yeah, you know what? I mean, I think, you know, going in one, that Friday night game, you know, a tough game after traveling all night to get there and, you know, having a little quick morning skate and then afternoon nap and, you know, pregame and all that stuff or whatever. I kind of knew it was going to be tough, but, I mean, I thought we played well enough to give ourselves a chance to win. And, you know, at 5-3, or is that what the score ended up being, 5-3?
6-3 on Friday, yeah.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, I just think, you know, in this league, you know, the scoring ends up being higher than normal places, whereas goal scoring isn't too hard. But on my end, I think scoring 3 goals, we should be able to win. We should be able to win with 3 goals, and I don't think our goaltending was sharp all weekend. But obviously, we broke out and we played great on Saturday night, and we played a certain way. We played great defensively. We played great offensively, and then that third game in 3 nights, you know, I think anything can happen. And you know what? We got back to kind of some of our old ways, and we didn't pick up, didn't have some good reads. We had some turnovers that kind of got us kind of on our heels. And, you know, that three-game and three-night stint, something good happens, your energy level rises. Something bad happens, your energy level drops. And, you know, I think their goaltender, Shipman, I think kept them in the game in some aspects of it as well.
What do you think, though, on that Saturday game? Because, you know, Scott and I talked about it. Obviously, the big news, defensively speaking, was with Edgar Zolzalinch suspended, Josh Pietrantonio went in, played a full game on the back end. You had him mostly paired up with Ian White. And honestly, Scott and I thought he was a natural back there for a guy who's obviously, you know, played forward for so long in this league. You put him back there. He got a little more physical, I think, than I was expecting, which was nice to see. And didn't really put a skate or a stick out of line too much. He was very effective back there, wasn't he?
Yeah, you know what? He got I don't want to pump his tires too much, but no, he did play well. He did get walked on a one-on-one. But, you know, if you're not used to playing that, that kind of tends to happen. But, no, you know, Petro, his strengths, you know, he's strong on pucks, and he's fairly aware of his surroundings, and he skates well. And you throw in, you play with an NHL defenseman that maybe, you know, doesn't quite have the step that he used to in the NHL, but his mind is there, and he's in the right position all the time. He just makes whoever he plays with easy to play with. You know, he makes a nice little bump pass, or, you know, he doesn't panic and this and that. So it kind of worked out really well. And, you know, I had to shuffle some lines around, and you know what? All three lines contributed on Saturday night. And you know what? We need that. And then coming in on Sunday, I think the biggest one of the other things, Ozo is back in the lineup, and then Jagger Williamson needed a night off with his leg. It was bothering him pretty bad. So, you know, then we had to shuffle lines again. So trying to get a little continuity out there, and obviously with Jags not out there, he's a big part of that hockey team, and you know, that was a little bit different than our normal lineup up front as well. So, and that didn't seem to work out as well.
Turning the page over now to getting ready to play the Carolina Thunderbirds, a 3-3 set. It starts up Friday night, and Friday, Saturday, Sunday, pretty much same as we had on the road in Port Huron. But now at home, friendly confines of the Columbus Civic Center, where the team has been phenomenal. I think that we've had 11 games so far at home. We have a 9-1-1 record. So, I mean, the team just plays very well on the home ice in front of the home fans. And, you know, you're going to have a spirited series with Carolina, because, you know, Southern hockey rivals, the history, anything you want to talk about in a storyline, it just builds into these three games are going to be very fun, very energetic. And what are you most focused on as the coach, getting them prepared to, all right, forget about the 3-9. Now we got to go and another 9 points are on the line against a team that's our rival.
Yeah, well, just to finish up with Port Huron, too. You know, one thing, and you can maybe tell me how many new players they had on the ice this weekend.
We eight. You know, that's, we saw eight skaters new from New Year's Day this weekend.
Yeah, you know, so that's, you know, and they added some quality players there. So, you know, you got to give them credit. You know, they played well, and not that we played terrible, but it's a different hockey team. You know, so, you know, with that point, with that said, you know, I thought we played well enough to win 2 out of 3, and we just didn't get it. We didn't get the saves that we needed to, be honest with you. Fast forward to this weekend, you know, Winston-Salem, kind of the same thing. I think, you know, they'll probably have a full roster, I believe. And, you know what, if we play the way we did on Saturday night and continue to play that way, and obviously we do like playing at home, you know, we should be all right. And, you know, I would like to think it will be a good test, and, you know, a battle. I mean, we don't like them. They don't like us. And, you know, I think, the other thing that didn't happen this weekend, as much as I'd like, is we weren't as physical as we needed to be. I think Port Huron probably has a little bit more scoring punch than Winston-Salem. But I think Winston-Salem does play a more traditional style game, and, you know, they're physical and they do a lot of things right. And, you know, we're going to have to match their physical play with hard work. And, you know, I think with our talent, I think our talent will take over. But hard work trumps talent if the talent doesn't work. So we really need to buckle down and work our butts off this weekend.
Last one here before we let you go, so you can get back to it, and we'll be taking a break after this too. But just, you know, the spirit, the mood of the team on their way or on the ice for practice today, because obviously, you know, not the way the weekend you wanted it to go, and then Monday getting in about mid afternoon because obviously long trip back, had to deal with a little bit of the snowstorms that obviously the whole mid Atlantic was dealing with. So long bus ride, legs, whatever it might be, but now you're on the ice Tuesday, and it's a short week to prepare for this 3-3. So what's the mood? What's it like on the ice down there with the guys?
Yeah, you know what? We had a pretty good skate this afternoon. I mean, had a little talk with them, and I think guys were pretty ticked off. And, you know, just how the weekend went and this and that, and nobody's happy about it. So, you know, again, kind of do some video probably tomorrow and still and show them, guys, this is what happened Saturday night. This is what happened Friday and Sunday. And you know what? If we want different results, we gotta be disciplined in what we're doing and play the same way all the time. And like that Saturday night game, I thought was our best hockey game, best 60 minutes all year. We played we didn't take one shift off. We didn't have, yes, we did make mistakes, but we were positionally sound to, if you did make a mistake or if somebody did make a mistake, we were in the right position to counteract what happened, type thing. So, yeah, the mood, we had a spirited practice. We did some one-on-one. We did some battling, and I think that's, if anything, that we're lacking is, you know, we can't just throw our stick in there and expect to win that puck. We got to throw our shoulders in there and put some weight in there and win that battle. And you know, the games that we didn't win this weekend, I didn't think we battled as hard as we did on Saturday night. So the mood was all work today. So tomorrow will be a little lighter, and you know, try to focus on getting our mind straight and knowing what we need to do to win.
He's the head coach, Jerome Bichard. Thanks so much for taking some time with us. Glad the skate was good, and we look forward to seeing what the team's got on Friday. You have a good one, Coach.
Sounds good, guys.
Thank you. Well, there you go, Scott. You heard it from Jerome. Obviously, things going pretty well for the guys. Not in the not where they wanted to be, obviously, the way the Port Huron weekend went, but obviously looking to turn the page and get right back at it against Carolina this weekend.
Yeah, and they were upset, which is good. They probably heard you say some negative things about them.
Oh, me?
This week.
Oh, okay, good. Yeah, I figured. It wouldn't be the other guy who was on the broadcast.
No. Not by the way, I have to say, give a shout out to two people.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Sully and Indigo. Big listeners,
Sully.
Big fans.
Sully, not Sully.
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 Yeah, Sully and Indigo. Big fans.
Let's take a break. When we come back, we close out tonight's John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show after this on the Columbus River Dragons Radio Network.
The Chattahoochee's favorite place for spirits in the valley is John Emerald Distilling Company in Opelika. Conveniently located in beautiful downtown Opelika, they're open Monday through Saturday for tours, tasting, and bottle sales. Not in Opelika? No problem. From Birmingham to Columbus, there's plenty of places where John Emerald originals are sold. Check out some of their favorite recipes at johnemeralddistilling.com and give them a follow on social media at JED Spirits on Twitter and Instagram.
Dressing for success is as easy as 1-2-3 with Wade Cleaners. Drop off your garment at any one of their 5 convenient branches or call their valet manager to pick them up. Go do something fun, walk your dog, eat a hot fudge sundae, or go to a movie. Leave the dirty laundry to them. Pick up your professionally clean garments or have them delivered at no additional charge to your home or office. Yes, you too can dress for success with Wade Cleaners. Oh, and don't forget the little people, as as you move up in the world.
At Southern States Bank, the Common Sense Bank, we're a true community bank that supports the places we serve. Our people live, work, and play in your community. And you will find us cheering for the River Dragons right alongside you in the stands. With convenient locations throughout Alabama and Georgia, we're never too far away to handle any of your financial concerns. Call, click, or come by and see how we can help you make sense out of your banking. Visit us online at southernstatesbank.net. Southern States Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. NMLS number 410611.
Progress. It's the belief that your life should be easier, that life should be fun, and that the best is yet to come. With us, you have a provider who pours everything into bringing progress home. And it's not just some big name in a faraway glass tower. That provider is here. That provider is Beam. With local service and faster internet, the only place you're going is forward. And we're taking you there. Progress. Your Beam. Your way.
Before you know it, the weather will get warmer and baseball will be right around the corner. So book your summer weekends early by purchasing a Flight Club membership with the Columbus Chattahoots. Flight Club members receive tickets to every home game at Golden Park as the Hoots try and go back to the championship series in 2022. Plus, more awesome perks for all of our members. Visit GoHoots.com to get started on securing your membership for the 2022 Sun Belt Baseball League season. Or call the offices at 706-507-4600.
Back here at the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show on a Tuesday night, just about 7 or 8 minutes left in today's program. We just heard from Jerome Bichard over the phone. I'm proud of myself for able to make that work. Never been formally trained on that. So that was, we always like to joke about me getting the keys to the car here and try not to crash it. Well, apparently they put a little trailer on the back of the car and I got it hitched up somehow.
The Getmo box.
Scott Brand is with us here. No player guests because if you were listening during the last segment, guys just got off the ice for an afternoon practice.
And they were mad at Zach for saying stuff.
Sure, mad at me. Okay. Well, let's talk about that, though, because obviously we had some fun during last weekend. Got to be on the air television-wise on WTVM Bounce 9.2. And you've already told the news that the TV coverage will be expanding with a couple of Sunday games, thanks to our partners at Jordan Communications, which will be in the Auburn-Opelika area. I can't wait until the podcast comes out, and you're going to get a little ripped at for the Opelika. The Opelika area, but that's fine.
That's how you say it in Georgia. It's at my Southern Georgia accent that we have.
Yes, the Southern Georgia accent you've been developing for a bit. Either way, going to be a lot of fun. And television, I mean, were we looking to, bring that up and just improve that in a whole bunch of different ways? I know people enjoyed seeing you and me on there, riffing it up, having some fun.
Let's not say they enjoyed seeing us. Enjoyed having the show broadcast.
Yeah, well, listen, I was taking this somewhere. It's just, maybe next time we'll have a little security detail help us out.
You mean the guy climbing up the ladder as we're on live television?
I thought that was, what's funny is a little behind-the-scenes story is, I have a lot of family from Michigan, so they come, and when I'm in Port Huron, they usually see me, and I like to bring them up to the press box during post-game, because it's usually very chill. Port Huron guys are tearing down. I'm in my half of the press area and nobody really ever bugs us. It's like, all right, we're having fun and I'm catching up with family in between segments. And this particular time, there was just somebody there working. I had never seen anybody climb up that ladder to go into the catwalk or do anything after a game in Port Huron ever. And I would know because I'm always aware of it because I usually have family members all around me. That particular time, obviously couldn't because we were on TV. And what were we, 30 seconds in? And I'm getting nudged and bumped while I'm on live. I'm like, excuse what?
Well, what's funny is, and again, remember, and people, I'm sure, there's no more magic on anybody's on TV these days as proof, that we're on.
Thanks.
So, there's a camera. We've got this camera at us and we've got these marks on the ground. And we've got the surrounded area behind or around us, and next thing, this guy's staring at both of us, and of course we're trained to occasionally look at each other like we really care about what each other says, and look at the audience, right?
Right.
So the audience
folks
doesn't
on
think
the camera.
Hey, these idiots aren't looking at us, and here's this guy coming up, and he kind of pushes you and opens up the catwalk, and you know, there goes his butt crack right up the catwalk and goes up there. And I was thinking, okay, well, maybe he'll at least give us the courtesy.
Nope.
Came back right down, two minutes later, and you're just sitting there thinking, what the hell is going on?
I will say, I had a pretty good conversation with the Carolina broadcaster Dylan Clark yesterday. We were talking about the upcoming weekend, just exchanging notes, exchanging stories, because they were obviously in Delaware, and then the snowstorm hit, and they were playing in front of maybe, what, 100 or so people in the annex on Sunday. So we were exchanging some stories back and forth, and we brought up to that, and I showed him. I was like, did you see the end of the broadcast? And he goes, no. And, man, he was laughing. Everybody, you know, it's unplanned. It's unscripted. It's live television. You know, stuff like that's going to happen. But, yeah, just a little bit wild. But hopefully next time we do TV, we'll have a little better security. It'll help that we'll be at home, so I don't think we'll get too many intruders with it. But I can't say that's a 100% impossibility.
Sunday on Channel 18.
That's right.
If you're over in the Opelakan, in is it Opelakan?
Opelika.
Opelika.
Lika. You like Opelika.
Opelika.
There you go. See? Auburn. It's that easy. Yes, the Opelika Auburn area. Very excited to be bringing
Eastern
that television
Alabama.
Market. Yeah. Just say Eastern Alabama. That's an easy catch-all for you.
You know what? You got a lot of news. You got to break that news.
Yep.
I think you're breaking news tomorrow about something else.
We got the press release from the McDonald's, the ugly sweater jerseys. Obviously, that came in. And with it being a 4-for-22 game, or not 4-for-22, 4-for-48 game coming up the Saturday against Carolina Thunderbirds. McDonald's will be in the house, so of course that's when we'll do our Ronald McDonald House press and our giant check and everything. That'll be fun with that. So lots of things coming down the pipe. It's a lot of fun.
18.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun right now.
And then other sports.
The Columbus Chattahoots.
Like, we had massive signings.
We have. But we haven't gotten them any yet because we're waiting. We're building up the team. We got some time here. You know, it's still, what, I think 5 months? Four and a half months, roughly. But it'll
be here before, yeah.
Oh, it absolutely will. But, you know, just know once the calendar turned to 2022, the organization as a whole, I know, turned its page and started to peer an eye forward in 2022. Not only the Columbus Chattahoots, but Ignite Sports' latest property, the Chocolaca Monsters in Oxford, Alabama.
Which I'll be heading up to tomorrow and getting some things done on Wednesday and Thursday.
How have things been going up there? Because I know you and Diego Wilson, who fans might not know too much. He was a big behind-the-scenes guy, corporate partnerships and whatnot, not always, you know, in the forefront of everything. But Diego, I mean, he's obviously a mover and shaker. He's a guy who gets stuff done. And I know he's been up in Oxford for a little bit. You and him have been getting the start up there. Give us a little lowdown.
He's running the show. I mean, today a big sponsor signed on up there. Of course, we've got radio up there. We believe that Lineville, you're going to become Monster fans, so you'll be joining the broadcast family up there as we kind of split off a little bit.
I can't believe the Chattahoots are losing some of their network to the Monsters.
No.
I mean, this is you really want to start a rivalry like this, Scott?
Listen, I'm not picking favorites. You know, I hope it's us in the finals. You know, but I think we're kind of in the same division.
Yeah, that's we'll let the league announce all that when it comes to it, when schedule time comes. But it's going to be interesting because obviously we know the interesting part of being in an odd number team league this year, 7-team FPHL. Well, there'll be a 9-team Sunbelt league. At least everything goes according to plan because the Chocolaca Monsters. And I say that not because the Monsters are the Hoots, because who knows what the other Atlanta teams might be having going on.
Well, but that's true. And here's the other thing is we know opening night here will be Saturday.
June 4th.
And up there will be Friday, June 3rd.
Yep.
It's going to be interesting to own two teams in the same league. I mean, mm-hmm. You know, hockey-wise, they do it in the Fed all the time.
They do.
Two separate organizations, kind of separate organizations. I mean, you kind of do double duty with the behind-the-scenes stuff.
Yeah, but I'm anticipating being the, like, Columbus branch person, unless I get transferred, who knows, but you know, having all that, and then Oxford is just going to become its own thing, the Chocolaca Monsters, and it's just seeing the Ignite family grow just a little bit more.
It is, and Diego do a great job up there, and of course, you know, we'll have lots of Hoot stuff to go. So the organization's doing well, you know, but focus right now is ice hockey, and Big games coming up this weekend, Zach.
They are indeed. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, the Carolina Thunderbirds are in town taking on your Columbus River Dragons. Should be a lot of fun. 7:30 puck drops on Friday and Saturday. Sunday puck drop is at 4:30. Catch all of the games on the River Dragons Broadcast Network here on radio, on YouTube, and on television twice this weekend. Or no, just once this weekend with Channel 18. But next weekend, we're on Bounce 9.2 with Port Huron game. That'll do it for this edition of the Coach's Show. Scott, big thanks for coming out here in the studio, riffing it up with here with me. It was a lot of fun, something we haven't done in a little bit.
Do I get the extra 5 minutes that
No, unfortunately you don't, because I have to take this back to regularly scheduled programming at the top of the hour. So unfortunately, that will do it for tonight's show. Thanks so much, everybody, for listening in, and we will see you on Friday on the Columbus River Dragons Radio Network.
Listening to the John Emerald Distilling Coaches Show on the Columbus River Dragons Radio Network. Tonight's show was brought to you by John Emerald Distilling, Southern States Bank, BioLife Plasma, Midas Total Car Care, Vector Ply, and PMB Broadcasting. All rights to this broadcast are reserved for the private use of our audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, or other distribution of the descriptions or accounts of the show may not take place without the express written consent of Ignite Sports and Entertainment and PMB Broadcasting. This has been a presentation of the Columbus River Dragons Hockey Club.